Welcome to part 7. So in this part, we're going to add light trace in the factory. So we're importing a model and we're going to use an array modifier to put all these light trace along each other, adding some randomness, and then we're putting them on top of the factory and making some duplications. We're also adding area lights. We're putting these at the bottom of the light trace, and this way we have a second light source in the factory. So we have environment light and we have light from the area lamps. So that's pretty much for this part. So let's work on the lights. And welcome to part 7 of the factory construction. So in the previous part, we worked on these pillars. We get the material preview. So we aligned them in a row and there is a pillar on top. And also in the other room, we have the pillars and they come with a function. Not only they add value in the scene as a construction value, but also we just go to render view. They divide the room into separated parts. Without these beams, it's a very large space. So by adding these pillars, it's way more in balance. So it has a function as well. It's not just for fun. What I like to do, what we're going to do in this part, is focusing on the light, on the lamps, on the steel beams. So we can see there are some beams on top. We're going to add the lamps. So how that works, we're not going to model them. Modeling these light trays, light lamps, will be a course on itself. So instead, we're appending these from a blend file that comes with this course. And you can import them and put them in the right collection. And then we can start putting them on the steel beams. So that's what we're going to do. So first, I like to add a new collection. And we're calling this, let's say, lights and underscore area. And for the factory, let's minimize these. We make lamps. So that's good. So now we're going to append. So appending goes like file. And with append, you can look in a different blend file. So we go to models and we're opening this blend file. So you can pick what you want to append. Well, we want to append an object and all of these objects. Here we go. So they're right there. So I'm pressing control, pressing G and control, and it will be nice. I just enabled it, but I have to do it again. Not so stable. I'm pressing point, so it's zooming in to the center. So what do we have? We have these ceiling light trays. We will start with these. And then we can hang them on these bars. I don't know exactly the name for it, but they're functional. And in the end, we will put the lights underneath the light tray. So I like to start with these. So we press Shift D and we're moving them right there. Go to the wireframe and you can see the beams right here. So that's nice. So we drag them a little bit inside. So you don't want to push them to the wall. So a little bit of space is needed. And instead of just duplicating them all over again, we're going to use an array. So we go to the Modify tab, Add Modifier, Generate, and you see Array. And there's also Array Legacy. You maybe ask yourself, why are there two types of arrays? Well, Blender 5 now comes with an array that uses geometry nodes, and you have way more functionality on this. And we will use that on the light lamps, not on these trays, to add some randomization on it. So we start with this. And if we zoom in, you can see what's happening. It's duplicating it two times. So you have, in fact, you have three light trays on the X axis. So make this 0 and start with 1. So now they are close to each other. And I like to have a count of 10. And you can see there is more space right here. So I like to GY, drag this a little bit. So let's go to the side and drag them more upwards. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. A little bit more GY. I'm counting the blender grids. Like 1, 2, 3, 4, and a little. That's really hard to see, but it, in fact, it doesn't really matter. So we have one light row, and now we have to find the distance. So I'm pressing, let's go to the front view. It's a lot of twitching between modes, front view, right view, top view. That's hard to see. We're pressing G key and Z and drag this downwards. Now we go inside. Oh, it's really hard. And press, so I want to have this in the middle of this beam, something like this. That feels good. All right, so far so good. We go to the next object, this part. We're going to hang them. And what we'll do is duplicate it. I'm putting it right here to start with. And then we're going to put this upwards. I thought it was inside, but we have to drag this right here. So here we go. So you don't want it to pop out. This is good. And we're using an array for this part as well. So go to add modifier, generate array, make this 0. And I want to have a count of 8 for this one. And we're going to increase the Y. Like this. So it's going to the end. So this yellow line is the end. And we'd like to use something that looks like this. Okay. But they're now floating in the air. So we're going to the original one. We're selecting this. And GZ key. And we're going to merge this with the beam. And now we have this. It starts to look like something. So there's one more essential part, and that's the light itself, or the lamp. So we're dragging this right here. And let's start at this position. It's really hard to see, so we have to do some moving. Oh, that's the wrong part. We want the lamp. Shift D. My mistake. I'm sorry. All right, so here we go. We direct this upwards. GZ. Just attach this on the light ray, something like this. Okay. Needs to be in the middle. Little bit of tweaking. And we're going to use an array for this one as well. Make this 0. And I like to use a count of 7. And we're going to increase this. So, to me, this looks good. How does it look like in the viewport? Okay, just checking everything if it's not looking weird or odd. So this one is overlapping, so we just move this a little bit backwards. Like to check the start. Okay. So, as mentioned, we have the array. This is a new array using geometry nodes. Click randomize, and you have this tab rotation. If I move this, you can see they start to rotate a little. I kind of like this effect because you add some randomization, so they're not looking straight. It's a very subtle effect, but I kind of like it. You can do this with like anything. If you have books, or other things, you just randomize them and it looks so more natural. Okay, so we have them all aligned. So now we go to light area, and we go to add light area. Okay, and we're moving this light over here. And instead of using a square, I'm using a rectangle, making it smaller. Like this, a little bit taller, GY, Let's take a look where it is. Moving it upwards, G and the Z key, close to each other. So you maybe think, why not using an emission? Well, by default, there is an emission, but I want to have more impact on the scene. The scene can generate quite a lot of noise, and by adding some area lights, we avoid noise. We still have noise, but less. So I don't want to do Shift D because I want to have one value to change to impact them all. So instead, we do Alt D, G Y, and Alt D. Just you can use Control or just move them naturally. That's fine. Alt D, like this. And Alt D, we're almost there. And again, how does it look like? Looks all good to me. So what's left is we're selecting all the area lights, the light armatures, the light ceiling, or what is it? It's called the seal light tray and the hanging system. And we press Alt G again, G, X, move them to the right. Again, Alt D. And Alt D. All right, perfect. And we have lights in the scene. So how does this look like? We go for a render. So it's rendering, and the great thing is use Alt D. If we select one light, and for example, we make this one, all the lights are dimmed. If we make this 20, so the impact, the power is very bright. So I like the default value of 10, and we're going to use a little of a yellowish color, something like this. So, it has a warm tint. Sunlight is more white and the lamps are more warm. All right, so long story short, so everything looks good. What I'd like to do now is also put some lights here on the beams over there. So I like to simply duplicate it, get rid of the array. And we're going to put these lights over here, like this. And align them a little bit. How does it look? Yeah, it's not really visible, so here should be, there you go. And two more on the, let's put them right here so we can just press Alt D, put them right here. Yeah, it's barely visible. But what we will do is also use this area light. It's selected. I hope so. Yeah. Alt D, putting it right there. We have to put this in position, otherwise it's not effective. And we're simply duplicate it on all the lights, like this. Alt D. Cool, very well. So at this point, we fixed the lighting, or we added the light. The only thing we need to do from this point, and we will do this in another part, that's not essential for now, is adding HDRI lighting, because now we're using a more procedural sky, pretam, and a sunlight, I want to have the most realistic light available, and you can achieve that by adding an HDRI. So so far so good for the lighting. We're going to wrap this part up because it's finished. They're all hanging and that's nice. So what I'd like to do in the next part is focusing on the doors. That's quite a lot of modeling. There's a large door with a gliding system and the smaller doors. And they all have quite a lot of parts. So we need to take some time to make that work. So thanks for watching this part, and I'd like to see you in the next one. Bye-bye.